Hello and welcome to Technical Skills YouTube channel. This is Shafaqat Ali with another video of Android development. So in the last videos we have created this beautiful UI in our Android application. So now in this video we will perform the Firebase authentication in our Android application. So in this video we will perform the email and password authentication in our project. So for this we have to connect our project to Firebase database. So for this we have to click on the tool, and here we have to select the Firebase. Okay, now here we have to select the authentication. So here we have authentication tab, so just click on it, and here we have to perform the email and password authentication. So we can select any of them, every authentication is same. So just we have to click on the authentication using the custom authentication system. So here we have to click on the connect to Firebase. So here we have to create new account. So here I will create the Firebase auth all. So here we have to click on the continue to create the project. Scroll down and here we have to click on the continue. So here we have to select our project name. So click on the accept and create new project. Okay, now click on continue. And here we have created the project. So we have to select the authentication. So wait for loading. Okay, now here we have to click on the connect. Okay, our Android Studio is connected to our Firebase database. So here we have to open our Android Studio. So here we have to add the Firebase authentication SDK to our Android application. So just click on it and accept changes. Okay, now our dependency is adding now. So we have to open the project. So here I will open my project authentication. Okay, so here I will select the authentication. So I will open the Firebase database again, and here we have to select that project, and then we have to select the authentication. Okay, now click on the get started. Now we have to select the email and password authentication. So just click on this edit, and here we have to enable it. And now click on the save. Okay, now go to Android Studio. So here we have to initialize all the variables. So just open the XML code of the registered activity. So here I will press Ctrl B to open the XML code. Okay, now we have input field for email and two input field for password. So we have to create one by one. So we will create the edit text for email. So edit text, input email. Okay, I have initialized all the variables. So here you can see we have initialized. Now we will set click listener on the BTN register. So here I will set click listener on the BTN register button. So set on click listener, new on click listener. Okay, so here we will perform the authentication. So let's say I create the method perform authentication, and here I will press alt enter to create the method inside our registered activity. Okay, now we have to get the text from the input field. So here I will create the email, and here I will get the email from the input field. So get text dot to string, and here I will get the password. So input password dot get text dot to string. So now again for confirm password, so here I will create confirm password. Okay, now we will check either our input field empty or not. We will validate the data. So here we have to add this line for validation of the email. So I have created already, you can Google it, you can get many validation pattern for email. So here I have created this one. So first of all we have to check for email. So if email dot match, and here we have to pass the pattern. So here I will pass the email pattern, and here we have to add if email does not match the our pattern, so we have to show toast message. So here we will add the error to input field. So input email dot set error, and here we have to pass enter correct email. Okay, now we will check the password. So here else if password dot is empty, our password dot length is less than 6 character, so we have to again show the error input password dot set text set error enter proper password. Okay, now we will check for confirm password. So here else if password dot match dot equal, and here I will confirm password, and if it is not matched then we have to error and we have to show the error. So here confirm password input confirm password dot set error password not matched. Okay, now finally we will create the progress dialog. So at the top we have to create progress dialog. So progress dialog, and here we simply call it progress dialog. So here we have to initialize it. So here we will create equal to new progress dialog, and here we will pass the context. Okay, now here we have to initialize the progress dialog. So here progress dialog dot set message, and here we will call registration. Progress dialog dot set title, and here we have to show please wait while registration. So here we will call simply registration. Okay, so progress dialog dot set outside touch cancel, and here we will pass false, and finally we will show the progress dialog. So here we simply call progress dialog dot show. Okay, so now we have to create the member variables of the Firebase database. So here at the top we have to create the instance of the Firebase database. Okay, here we have to create the Firebase auth. So here we will create Firebase auth m auth. So if it will not show, you have to rebuild the project. So just have to click on the build and click on the rebuild project. Okay, now we will create Firebase user. So here I will create Firebase user m user. Okay, so we have to initialize it. So here we have to initialize m auth equal to Firebase instance Firebase auth dot get instance. So Firebase user m user equal to m auth dot get current user. Okay, so here we have to inside this else method, so here we have to initialize it. So m auth dot create user with email and password. So here we have to pass the email and then password, and then here we have to pass add on complete listener new on complete listener. Okay, so first we have to put a semicolon here, and here we have to check if task is successful, then we have to dismiss our progress dialog. So first we have to dismiss our progress but dialog, so dot dismiss, and then we have to show toast message. So here I will call registration successful. Okay, in else state, so here we have to create else and progress dialog dot dismiss, and we have to show simply error. So here we will create task dot get exception. Okay, so if our task is successful, then we have to send user to next activity. So here we will create another method, send user to next activity. So here we will create this method. So press Alt Enter to select method, and here we will create the intent to send user to next activity. So intent equal to new intent, and this is our registered activity, and target activity is our main activity. So here we will create the another activity, that is home activity, not main activity. So right click here, and here we will select the activity, empty activity, and this will be my home activity. Okay, so home activity is good. Okay, inside registered activity, here we will pass the home activity dot class. Okay, now we will set some flags to intent. So intent dot set flag, and here we will create the intent dot clear task, and then intent dot new task. Okay, this will stop to come back to over this activity when user successfully registered. So here we will call start activity, and here we will pass this intent. Okay, so let's run the application and let's see our registration is successful or not. Okay, our application successfully running. So let's click on the create new account, and let's say I click on the register. So here you can see it showing the error. So here we have to pass the email. So let's say I type here email test@gmail.com, and let's say I type here password. I type 7 character. Okay, let's click on the register. So it's loading, and here you can see your registration is successful. Okay, now go to authentication users, and here you can see our authentication email is available. Okay, now we will perform the login. So here we have to open our main activity, because login activity is available inside main activity. So here we have to press Ctrl B to open the XML code. We have to initialize all the variables. So let me open the registered activity again, and here we will copy the edit text and button. So here I have to copy the edit text and button, and also we have to copy all the Firebase authentication initialization. So here we will simply paste, and here we have no need of the confirm password because this is login. And here inside of PTN register we need login, and that's it. So here we will create the initialize the input emails. So instead of creating new one, we will just copy it. So here we have email and password, so just copy it, and inside main activity will be pasted. And again we will go back, and here we have to copy the progress dialog and authentication. So here we will copy, and again come here and just simply paste it here. Okay, now we need to add btn login equal to find view by id. So here we will create btn login. Okay, now we will perform the click listener on the btn login. So here again btn login dot set on click listener, new on click listener. So again we go back to our registered activity. So here we have to copy the all this code. Okay, now here we have to create the method perform login. So we will create the method. So here we will paste all the code. Okay, now we no need of the confirm password, and here we will check email is matches with email pattern, and here we have to show the error, and same like the this one. So we have no need to check the confirm password. Okay, instead of this please wait while registration, we have to pass here login. Okay, now here again we will pass login. Okay, now first of all we have to add a brackets. Okay, so now we will use mAuth dot sign in with email and password, and here we have to pass the email and again password. Now we will add on complete listener, new on complete listener, scroll down, and here we have to put the semicolon, and here we will check if task dot is successful, and here we have to again go back to register activity, and here we have to copy all the code, and here we have to paste it here, and this is our main activity. So here we will pass main activity, and here we have to pass the login. Okay, perfect. So now this method is missing, so here we will copy the method. So just copy this method and go to main activity again, and here we simply paste that method. Okay, now inside else condition, so here we again copy the else state, so just copy it, and here we will paste that one. Okay, now here we have to change the method into main activity, and again here we have to change the reference. Okay, so our login activity is also completed, so let's test it. Okay, our application successfully running, so let's say I type here test@gmail.com, and here I will pass the password, so that we have passed in the last authentication. So just click on the login and wait. Okay, now here you can see login is successful. So let's go back again. Here you can see our application is closed. So this is the authentication with email and password. So in the next video we will perform the authentication using the Google. So if you have any question, any problem, let me in the comment section. Please like my video, share my video, and subscribe my channel. See you next video. Take care.